Welcome to the beer stream, guys. It's RDU and Just Saying here, presenting you a very good quality Hearthstone series between Ignite and Ostkaka. First of all, I'm not sure why this game is not on the A stream. It's like a pleasure for us to cast this game. It's like pure Hearthstone.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be a very high quality match between two very, very strong players.
Now they started with their ban decks, I think, just... Just for us to spectate, it's not really an actual game.
Yeah, let's talk about the lineups then.
Ignite has Rogue, Zoo, Aggro Shaman left. And Ostkaka should have Druid, Zoo, what warrior? The OTK warrior. The thing is that Ostkaka runs the Zoo with Forbidden Rituals, and the Ignite runs the Zoo without Forbidden Rituals, so Ostkaka is like heavily favored in the mirror match.
Oh yeah, Ignite's playing the Wrathguard list with the Young Priestesses.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot more of the aggressive minions, but not so much of the sticky stuff in the Zoo mirror.
Like, on paper, Ostkaka has like two sweep decks. Like, Warlock can sweep. Warrior, not so much. Druid can sweep, and Freezmage got banned because it can also sweep.
You're just saying you can sweep with anything at this point.
Yeah. Well, like also like one spicy detail. Ostkaka said before the series to Ignite that he has like very little chance to winning, or no chance almost.
Yeah, looking at this lineup, it's actually pretty insane.
Yeah, yeah.
Ostkaka has a huge favor in Zoomir. He has a great warrior deck against the lineup, and Ignite was even forced to ban the Freezmage, leaving this OTK warrior up.
Yeah, yeah. This is like awful for Ignite. Ignite had a really good lineup against you, for example, but against Ostkaka, his lineup is like pretty shitty.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be much harder for Ignite, especially since the Shaman is mid-range as well. It just gives the OTK Warrior a lot of time as well. The Aggro Shaman would have been a little bit better against Ostkaka's lineup. The mid-range Shaman might be a little bit better against Ostkaka's Druid, but aside from that, Ostkaka comes in as a very heavy favorite in this match.
Yeah. The winner of this goes on to play Thais, and the loser plays Hoi. So this group is pretty stacked. None of these players are in like a shape that they want to be into.
Group D?
Yeah, Group D from Death.
Group D. Yeah, of course.
I'm not sure what are the seedings for top 8. I wouldn't want to face the second place of this group, for example.
Yeah.
Tomorrow. It's going to be pretty hard.
I mean, Thais, they put Thais, Hoi, Ostkaka, and Ignite in the same group. That's already pretty crazy. And there's two of them coming in.
They started the game.
Yeah, they're starting the first game.
We have Rogue versus Druid. So Ostkaka just goes for the Druid. He's like, yeah, let's free up with Druid. Ignite starts with the Rogue. Rogue is not that bad from Ignite. But
yeah,
Ostkaka has like a pretty good lineup
matchups,
against it.
Yeah. Oh, and Ignite comes in with a very strong hand. I mean, having the teacher and even like Conceal and Auctioneer already ready. Like, as long as Ostkaka doesn't ramp too fast, I mean, we see Ostkaka already has the Wild Growth, but as long as he doesn't hit like the Mire Keeper as well or anything like that, it's going to give Ignite enough time to make Auctioneer very impactful this game.
If Kaka picks up an Innervate, then it's game over, right? Mm-hmm. But if he doesn't, Ignite might be able to like have the tools to make
a
comeback.
But at the same time, Ignite picked up a prep. I mean, things are going really well both ways so far. It's hard to tell at this point who's really in the lead.
You just dagger here, right? You don't want to waste the coin that early.
What would you waste the coin on? The coin
SI.
Coin SI, go face.
Yeah, just show dominance.
It's actually a pretty hard turn for Ostkaka. Like, he doesn't really have much fuel outside his Vile Teacher and the ward. So, like, using the Vile Teacher directly on 4 and not gaining any board presence out of it might not be the best route.
Is there any situation where he just opts to not play the Vile Teacher because if Ignite managed to kill it, then he has nothing to play?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Don't even throw it out there this turn.
Mm.
But, I mean, it does give your opponent a lot of initiative. Maybe you have to? What do you think?
Yeah, I think you have to YOLO it. Look at Ignite's head. Let's analyze that for a second. I think the dubstep is like flowing through his body. He's feeling it. He's in the zone. Do you ever like prep Fan of Knives, SI Agent? Nah.
No, it's not enough. You can coin the teacher, I guess.
Ooh. Mm. I'd rather just like play the SI, the naked SI.
Naked SI? What are you going to do? How are you going to get rid of this teacher?
Well, if you play the teacher, how are you going to get rid of the teacher?
Well, if he has to trade with your teacher, the next turn the SI might be able to clean it up. Because it's still hard for Druid to clear the 3-5 on 5 mana. Like, Swipe doesn't quite clear it. You need, like, Wrath Roots or Mulch.
This guy's toast.
He attacks it.
That's very ambitious.
Yeah. I'm not sure if I like it. But there's, like, nothing better.
Oh, Noskaka even has the Onyxia, too.
Yeah, he can, like, Wrath Ball of the Wild. It's pretty good.
I mean, turns out playing the teacher out on 4 really pays off here. Ignite doesn't have the best answer for it. I mean, what do you think? It's a very ballsy play, but if it sticks, I mean, Osaka now at this point just wins, right? Like, what can the rogue really do?
I mean, the rogue can do stuff. He can, like, prep Fan of Knives
into
Fan of Knives, coin Eviscerate. I don't know, there are some situations. Like, for example, you can go, like, Teacher, Prep Fan of Knives, Top Deck Prep, Prep Fan of Knives. I mean, that's a bit...
You might be better off saying, okay, Osaka's played his power turn, and he probably doesn't have more stuff, right? He's not going to have another power or anything like that. And you can say, I want to play for the Auctioneer out or something. Because how are you really winning using this prep here?
Okay, what is the Auctioneer out then?
Oh?
Coin Auctioneer next turn, and then Prep Fan of Knives into Prep Fan of Knives.
Coin Auctioneer, like Prep Conceal or something, and then cycle the fans next turn, and then find a second prep for Eviscerate.
You're dead if you
Yeah, you might be. But how dead are you doing this play anyway? He's going to Coin Conceal, and then go from there.
Coin Conceal is an interesting line.
This is also a very good line. This will fight for the board.
Yeah, I like this line. Ignite showing his superior rogue skills, which is why you should bring rogue if you... Like, otherwise you shouldn't bring Rogue, if you're not, like, super confident on it. Same applies for Freeze.
Yeah, of course. Rogue, Freeze Mage, all these kind of combo-y decks. Of course, you have to be very, very practiced with it. Otherwise, bringing it can lead to very, very bad games for you.
Osaka has, like, no play currently, so...
Yeah...
Ignite has the initiative. He can, like, Cold Blood one of the shitty one-ones and trade into the... teacher, if he wants to. If he opts for that. You could Leroy. Prep. Leroy prep fan of knives. Trade the Leroy into the teacher. Trade the one-ones into the 2/2s. And then you're still left with some minions on your board, but that's probably not that good.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy just playing out the fan here.
Yeah, you just Cold Blood. Trade, wait, what? Oh, I guess this is fine.
Yeah, prep it again.
Prep it again and again. Prep for you, a prep for you, and a prep for everybody. Everybody's prepared, right, Popules?
Yeah, it hurts to play the Cold Blood now, but I guess you do it anyway. You picked up a backstab for Auctioneer, so Auctioneer's not entirely dead for you at this point.
He's not really the best Auctioneer ever.
Yeah, there's some consideration for saving the prep, but this is fine. Right, because how would you have done it? You want to trade the 1-1 into the teacher with Cold Blood, save prep for a spell, right? And then trade dagger into 1-1 as well and just teacher go face.
Yeah, I could have done that.
Yeah, I think maybe you would have saved prep there.
But yeah, then you take some more face damage.
Why didn't you bring rogue? That was definitely the correct line.
Why did I not bring rogue?
Yeah. You pointed out a better rogue play right there, right?
I don't know. With what I brought, I'm already top 8, so...
Ooh.
I'm not sad of what I brought. Thank you. Wow. This is, like, insane. Like, the amount of tempo that you get by sapping an entry to 404 is, like, monstrous. Like, you kill 7 mana from your opponent for only 2 mana.
Yeah.
So you, 7 you, mana. You, so basically, you pay... 1/4 out of your turn to like deny your opponent's whole turn. And then the Tomb Pillager is the other part of your turn, which completely like leads to you fucking him up. Basically. More or less.
Well, what does Osaka want to do?
Concede?
Is it time? Are you gonna go nourish, mold something, and then pray for Yogg-Saron next turn?
Nah. I think it might simply be better to play the war again.
Have war soak the damage.
It's very it's very unlikely that he's gonna have another sap.
Yeah, but then what do you do next turn? Anixia is not the play. Are you really trying to set up Anixia?
Can this be lethal in any way, shape, or form?
For Ignite?
I think you...
5, 5, 11, no?
Hmm?
I mean... Yeah, yeah, what were you saying?
I was wondering if this can be lethal.
No, it shouldn't even be close. He's got a 5-10
on the board. 12, 12. So how do you do it? Trade? I'm not sure if I like the backstab first.
Yeah, I like saving it for Auctioneer. You can Auctioneer coin, backstab a 1-1, and still be fine. Yeah. Like, you're making very little use of your mana now. Unless you plan on Leeroy face as well.
Coin Leeroy.
Yeah, I mean, what else do you do with this line, right? You coin Leeroy. Otherwise, you're supposed to make the Auctioneer play.
I don't mind this, but it's a bit too greedy for my taste.
I mean, this is a very, very classic rogue turn. It's turn 7 and you use just 3 mana.
I don't know, it could have been maximum mana utilization. Like, you trade a 1-1, you play Auctioneer, you trade your Pillager. Yeah. Or you can just start by trading Pillager.
You trade
Pillager, you play Auctioneer, you backstab a 1-1, you coin, and you just draw something from the next two cards.
Yeah, exactly. You even refuel all the 1-1s that the teacher lost.
Ignite is still in, like, top tier spot. He can win next turn.
Yeah. Top tech, Cold Blood or an Eviscerate. He has 3 outs, I think. Shadow Strike.
That ain't it. Just Auctioneer coin. Hope for the best.
I mean, this should have been in play last turn, but...
Yeah, yeah.
It's the same. You're still praying for the spell to play with Auctioneer. It's okay.
I think Ignite can lose this. I mean, actually, Ignite lost it. He cannot win this turn, so Shaka has Yogg-Saron.
And so it's over.
Yogg-Saron is a pretty good card. Like, yeah. I don't know. The thing with Yogg-Saron is that it's cool to see it, like, once every 5 series. But seeing it, like, every single series at least once is a bit too much for me.
I mean, I remember our series where we saw 3 Yoggs. All from me.
All from you. I'm not even sure if I play Yogg in any of my decks. I don't think I play Yogg in any of my decks.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, you clearly didn't get the memo. Yogg-Saron's the best card in Hearthstone. Shadow Strike 1-1-2. Wow.
That's a bit too fancy. I'm not sure if I like it.
I mean, Shadow Strike is generally a very good card against Druid. You want the card, you want to try and set up lethal. The Leeroy already kind of does it for you next turn. I would have probably saved it.
Here you start with Raven Idol, right? You go Raven Idol, try to like fetch something that you can also play with the Innervate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you Raven Idol into like another 1-mana spell into like Innervate.
Like find like a Naturalize or something just in case Yogg goes wrong.
No, you play it before Yogg.
For one spell? Or do you want to play afterwards just in case something happens?
I have no clue. Let's see what he has.
What if the Auctioneer gets double kingsed and you have to get rid of it?
Astral Communion is the pick here. If you want to lose the game.
Astral
Communion. Just for the memes.
Oh.
Now you probably take Mark of the Wild, right?
It's yeah, like yeah, of course.
Strictly better than Mark of Y-Sharai or Isharai or however the heck he's named. Nobody plays him anyways. Unless you have like a beast in your deck.
Yeah, people saw this card, and when the expansion came out, they thought, wow, Beast Druid is really going to be a thing.
I mean, we saw Beast Druid doing pretty well in prelims.
Mm. Wow. Yeah, Oskaka still wants to edge the Yogg a little bit more.
I call this no balls. Or very small balls. Mulch.
Well...
Like, now Ignite has an out.
Yeah, just needs to find the extra damage for this Leeroy.
Easy.
Ooh, there it is.
Easiest win of Ignite's life. Yeah? I don't know, I think Kaka should have Yogg'd last turn. Should have believed.
There was really no better time for Yogg, but how many spells does Kaka have?
don't know. If it was 8 plus, he should have yogged. If it was under 8, I don't know. Probably his line was better.
I think Osaka, just as a player, is so analytical.
Yeah, so calculated. Yeah.
He doesn't really want to rely on the RNG. Yeah. Only if he really can't win from that
then
spot.
Then why the fuck do you play Yogg in the first place? You can play the Druid without Yogg and do a really good job without it.
Yeah, I mean, Life Coach took Yogg Druid to this deck and to this tournament, and he cut Yogg, right? He just put in Cenarius and Onyxia.
Yeah, I cut
and said
too.
We don't need it.
Yeah, you have very similar.
Yeah, so...
Chito doesn't like this kind of useless RNG.
The
and
RNG,
me and Life Coach
yeah.
made top 8. Like, you can play Druid without Yogg, guys. Who'd have guessed, right?
Well, turns out Yogg was pretty good there. We'll never know how that game could have ended, but...
Yeah,
Osaka
it could have been
moves
like three pyroblasts, to ignite his face. Could have happened. Can you deny that?
Yeah, we can't deny that. There was Yogg lethal somewhere in there.
Hmm. That's a pretty good hand from Ignite. The only thing that is missing is the coin.
Hmm.
Osaka's Warrior should sweep, right? Should be have sweep potential against Ignite.
I'm not too familiar with this matchup, actually. The Rogue versus the OTK Warrior. It should be still very Rogue favored, OTK Warrior favored, just because of the shield blocks and the extra healthy gain from that. It really depends on how well of a curve Ignite can put together here in the early game. Skaka decides only to keep the Blood to Ichor. It's fair enough.
By the way, is it Ichor or Icar? Or Icor? Icor.
I think it's Ichor.
Ichor, I don't know.
Would you keep Blood to Ichor on the play against Rogue? Like, just to play around Argent Squire?
Like, if you know your opponent has Argent Squire, then you probably like wait for the mulligan. He's most likely going to keep it.
Yeah.
But he can also keep Tomb Pillager.
Mm-hmm.
So... I don't know, it's a very hard decision. Maybe it's fine.
I mean, it's good either way. If you hit War Axe, you piece together the damage for killing Pillager very smoothly anyway. This should be fine.
Missed one damage if he re-daggers, which is the optimal line of play when your opponent plays Fire War Axe. You don't want to just like sacrifice your Ursa Agent that can be useful later on in the game.
Yeah, but it's only one damage compared to if you have your 3-4-5 curve, you never re-dagger until 6, so maybe you swing here and it means that you can't swing it to something else later.
Okay.
I'm happy just missing the one.
Hmm.
Like, okay, so if Osaka doesn't play War Axe, then Ignite is very happy playing SI. But I think Ignite is just happy playing SI anyway, so.
I think he only played it because he doesn't want to look bad on stream missing damage with a dagger. People be like, oh, you shitty rogue player. Learn to play, noob.
Well, I really don't think it matters that much in this matchup. Maybe against Control Warrior, it's super, super important, right? You want to hit every damage you can, but the OTK Warrior only has a certain amount of life.
Yeah, I don't mind it. Like, Azir Deccan Tomb Pillager is probably the correct play. In all seriousness, I was just meaning right here. Like, Ignite knows he's rogue. Like, for example, now you play Pillager, and then you have Azir Drake. No need to, like, attack with a dagger anytime soon.
Yeah, just keep holding that dagger. Well, that Blood to Ichor keep has really come into handy here. That's good. So the OTK Warrior has always just a couple of lines you can play every turn. If you want to really just be mana efficient here, you can play Slam and Loot Hoarder.
I mean, Blood to Ichor also is as good as slamming, right?
Yeah, you get the 2-2 on the board you set up to clear the Azure Drake next turn as well.
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather take the mana inefficient play and try and get the board back next turn, too. Yeah, Osaka recognizes he still needs to be very wary of Ignite's curve. This is a good play.
No, Ignite is gonna dagger the Loot Hoarder and play the Azure Drake, right? Most of the time.
Ooh. Is there some kind of Edwin play here? I mean, you just drew Argent Squire too, right?
Argent Squire, Eviscerate, Coin Edwin.
I mean, you can go Squire, Blood Mage, Coin Edwin too. You don't need to Eviscerate a 2-2, especially when you need all the damage to race him.
Yeah, but killing the board like makes sure that your opponent will not have an efficient way of executing your Edwin.
This is OTK Warrior, RDU. They have so many AoEs and ways to just pitch damage into the Edwin. I think like the 2-2 is very irrelevant to whether or not this gets executed.
Okay, I don't mind the Thanos. No balls.
It's fine. He's playing for a bigger Edwin next turn. They fit the conceal in too, right?
Yeah.
Ooh. Is there a commanding shout? Yes, there is. This is a very, very strong turn. Pyro, yeah. Commanding Shout, Coin, Battle Rage, and make the trade too.
Wow.
Yeah. And now we really see the power of this OTK Warrior.
The power of the OTK Warrior.
I mean, you clear board, you leave up a board that's only weak to fan, and then he has to waste his whole turn with fanning, right? And then you still even get all of this initiative. No?
Or not. I think he might wait with the Pyromancer for like Auctioneer.
What?
He might wait with the Pyromancer for the gadgets on
oh,
Auctioneer.
Oh, okay, yeah. To play on Auctioneer this turn, like Auctioneer Coin Conceal, yeah. Sure.
Now you can Squire a side Coin Van Cleef.
Yeah, I mean, this is very good too.
No balls.
He's going for.
Why would he not go for the coin play?
I mean, I definitely Coin Conceal, right? And this Edwin is too important to your game plan.
Yeah.
It's for 8. And then, again, with like Cold Blood, it can hit for 12.
And if you do not conceal it, I think you should have played the SI Agent.
Yeah, definitely. Well, Ignite is really valuing the coin and what it means to the Auctioneer plan, if and when it is drawn.
I don't know. He better make use of that fucking coin.
I mean, we got a decent clear going on here. It's not bad. Empire is pretty effective this turn, too. He has a second one for the Gadget Stand turn as well.
Like, how is Ignite going to, like, win this game?
I mean, it's very demoralizing when Pyromancer just kills your 6-6 Edwin, right? And you just keep drawing cards. You know the time will eventually come when Oskaka assembles this damage. And on Ignite's side, I mean, concealing that 6-6, or 8-8, or however big he could have made it, was a pretty big deal.
He can conceal a 3-3 now. Ops not to. He cannot even YOLO with Leeroy with this deck because most likely they'll have a way to deal with it.
Yeah. What do you think Oskaka does this turn? Because it's so weird, right? Because the Pyro and all this is all card draw, and you want to get all the pieces together, but I mean, the Emperor this turn, you can buy another turn and then just cycle everything next turn. You don't need too many combo pieces reduced to beat Rogue, right?
Yeah, it's a good enough Emperor here. Like, you get the value on Faceless, and that's pretty much what you need to like kill a Rogue. If it was like another matchup where they had like taunts, heals, or like more annoying ways of stopping your combo, then you'd need like the cost reduction on at least 2 or 3 cards, maybe on even 4 sometimes against specific decks.
Yeah, anything with Bog Creeper you might be a little more cautious of. But
who plays Bog Creeper?
It's just it's a Tempo Storm thing.
By the way, Emperor has better value now because he has a chance of surviving. Whenever Emperor doesn't like strictly instantly die, and there's like even like a 10% chance of him surviving, then the value like raises up because if he survives, he insta win.
Exactly.
So it's like 15% he insta wins the game. If Ignite cannot kill it.
That plus Oskaka has played a lot of Rogue in his days, right? So he knows when the opponent wants to go for that Auctioneer turn. He's made some pretty good reads that Ignite. Keeping this coin, holding it for so long, doesn't have Auctioneer yet. So he's assuming his hand is already pretty weak. And this Emperor, just reducing more of the Rogue's resource before the Rogue finds Auctioneer is such a huge deal.
There's no like efficient play, you have to fan Eviscerate.
I mean, this is just the YOLO turn, right?
Is it?
Yeah, you go Leeroy Coldblood on the SI, and then you go all face, and you say, you know what, this Emperor reduction does not matter to me, because we're killing you next turn.
Wait,
oh, no, you Coldblood the...
No, you don't Coldblood the Leeroy.
Yeah.
There's no world where you Coldblood the Leeroy, right?
Of course not. It just has less health than the SI.
Yeah. What is Ignite doing?
He's, Well, I guess you pray, because if they have the AoE, you lose anyway, right? And generally, you would have two or three AoE.
Yeah, I guess it's pretty late. That's why you don't bring Rogue. That's why if you have like if you have Druid, you don't need to like play perfectly. And you don't get like that punished for your misplays. Feels bad, man. I really hope he doesn't go on Teal. I want to see like a good quality series after this.
I mean, this is so insane. Oskako draws his whole deck, clears the whole board, and it gets everything reduced by Emperor in the whole process. You couldn't ask for a better turn for this.
Yeah, this is like the 15% that I was telling you about. Where Kaka just takes it.
Yeah.
Rip Ignite.
So I guess Oskako wants to find Shield Block to be as safe as possible, but with Leroy gone, you don't even need it. Wow, look at these cards. Hey, even the whelps survive.
Like, the way Ignite can win is if Oskako overdraws. Only five cards left. 10 cards in hand.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, he will overdraw.
Yeah, that is a little scary.
What if he overdraws the Worgen? Wow, that would be amazing.
Well, this is a very good
fight. He has Fan of Knives too. Whoa!
Oh, no.
What the heck? Let's see.
Oh my god. Artie, you're so excited. You're like perching over to see the mulligan. Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's two cards milled, right?
Yeah, one more. One more. One out of three. 33%.
Oh, not like this. As a charge.
We can hear Ignite laughing. He's happy. He's enjoying himself.
So what does Oskako do then?
How does he charge it? He cannot win.
And there's no Leroy, but you can still you can still faceless something else, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, Ignite needs to top deck the Auctioneer to really seal this one in. But I think Oskako can take a value faceless, throw around some weight with the Rampage as well. Still do okay. Or Ignite just doesn't have an answer to a naked Raging Worgen, right?
Naked.
Yeah. What if he just buffs the Worgen with Rampage or something?
Jacks it up.
Jacks up that Worgen. These would be... Yeah, I like this play.
Wow.
Those are some big ghouls.
That's the line.
Yeah, it's a good
Interesting.
Line. It's a good line.
I guess Kaka still wins. The jacked ghoul is gonna take it.
This really does force Ignite to use all of his resources. Oh. Now, can he even... Now he even has to sacrifice Teacher. Unlucky.
Wow. This was so close. Oskako is tired. Like, we can see that Oskako is tired.
Yeah, he must
go to the bathroom.
a little shaken up from that game, definitely.
Yeah.
Huh? Quick bathroom break.
Yeah. Both players go to the bathroom and now we have to, like, somehow fuel in the gap. So Saiyan,
yeah.
What do you think about this game? It was so weird. Like, he could have like overdrawn Worgen too, and also the charge. I think like he went overboard with the draw. But if Ignite played it like
risky,
perfectly,
yeah.
I think he could have had like a better chance.
Yeah. I mean, definitely using the first conceal. I think if he used the first conceal the first time, right? He doesn't know this, but he top decks even the second conceal right afterwards.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Suddenly Edwin is just a huge win condition. But even connecting the first eight is insane already. Right.
Yeah, he had to like jack the Edwin, like just make a massive Edwin when he first could.
Yeah. I mean, you rely too much on Auctioneer when the damage and the conceal is already in your hand.
Yeah.
You kind of just have to go all in. Because you raced this deck, right?
Yeah.
And maybe after all of this time that Oskako was given, especially the Rogue not drawing Auctioneer, it just ends up becoming such a desperate plan for Rogue. And in the end, you know, you see him just Cold Blood Leroy and go all in. But you know, going all in on the Edwin would have been a little bit better, especially since he already had Conceal in hand.
Yeah.
But overall, it's a very, very good game.
The most important thing after a game like this and like such a long series at such a late hour is to just not teal. Just like keep your calm, focus on like what you need to do. There's still like hope for Ignite. Ignite has what? Ignite has Shaman and Warlock still left to beat that warrior. So he'll probably kill the Shaman because it's like more favorable than the Zoo. And then the Shaman should beat the Warrior. And then Oskako has like what left? The Zoo. And then Ignite has like two decks to beat the Zoo. which both should lose on paper. But still, let's assuming that they're both like 55 or 60%, Ignite is still like favored overall. Like, even if he's like unfavored with both, overall he still should beat it at least with one. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, even if you have like 40 and 40 with both decks, you still have like 40 to insta win. And then out of the remaining 60, you have 40. So 40 out of 60 puts you over 50% to like win the entire series overall. That's how it goes. Like, some guy can be like, oh, I have a deck that like is like 60% against every deck of yours. You're like, yeah, but I have 3 shots.
Yeah.
Like, well, still good enough.
Ignite should definitely just lead with the Zoo Warlock here. That's
really
an aggressive Warlock deck that isn't even good in the mirror, right? So if the aggressive Warlock deck can kind of just put on the pressure super early, don't let the OTK warrior assemble all the AoE, because Osaka is going to win that Warlock mirror anyway. So your Warlock deck is pretty useless. You just put it out right now, and then hope that the Shaman does something for you later.
Is the Zoomir...
It's pretty bad.
I don't know.
I mean, Ignite, yeah. I mean, he's got the hand, he's got his Wrath Guard, he's got Lance Carrier, I guess.
Yeah, look at Osaka's hand.
Yeah.
Osaka's hand is pretty good.
This is one of the... Oh, let me go for Peddler first. I mean, I throw out Wrath Guard here every time. Just clock in the damage while you still can.
Yeah.
What does he say when he enters?
I think
you will regret this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He will.
Yeah. Oh, well, I think Ignite makes the right play. Gives himself the best chance of coming back into the game. Oh, and this Bloodstone Corsair, you see?
That's why if you play like Peddler first.
If you play Peddler first, you get this exact card.
No, I think I would have played Peddler first. Like, if you see your opponent keeping cards, I think it's better to lead Winnie the Peddler. And if he has like the answer, you probably like just try to play something less important than the Wrath Guard.
Right, to test the waters for the War Axe, yeah. But
I don't mind the Wrath Guard. The Wrath Guard is like the most optimal play if you just want to like install in if he doesn't have it. I don't mind it. I think both options are fine for Ignite.
Oh, this is an interesting line.
Double Priestess and start praying?
Yeah, you go triple ones. Or just double? We want Lance carry this.
I'm not sure about this. I don't know. I guess it's fine. It's super bad if Osaka has like a whirlwind effect. Then he'll like milk Ignite.
That's such a strange way to put it. Yeah?
Yeah. He will. I don't know, like, what do you think about people playing this kind of zoo? I personally think it's like very, very suboptimal compared to like the standard list. Like, well, just because 6-0 won a tournament where everybody was playing subpar and like was bringing shitty decks, doesn't mean that deck is actually good.
Well, I guess in this case, especially this case, if Ignite's plan is to ban other people's zoo warlocks, then you want something more aggressive and more more unreliant on the rituals, right? Does he even run the rituals?
No, I don't think he runs the rituals in this deck.
Yeah, so that's kind of the point of the deck, right? You still leave up warrior, you ban your opponent's zoo, and then this zoo is overall a little bit stronger against some of the matchups that zoo traditionally would take longer to beat up.
Interesting.
Yeah, I mean, this is already insane. You've got the ghoul, acolyte, whole board for you. And very smart move by Moskaka to trade the acolyte first, just in this exact scenario, just thinking about whether or not he finds this ghoul. And Osaka knowing that Ignite doesn't run ritual is such a big deal as well, right? Because you might even hold back on the ghoul here if you think, you know, like he might ritual the next turn or something. But
yeah,
this
is
just simply not the case.
It's just a suboptimal zoo deck. Like, look at his hand.
I mean, this is pretty much GG.
Yeah.
And you keep on playing these Wrath Guards, and yeah, Osaka's happy to see it.
I want to see a Wrath Guard getting shield slammed. Then my day is complete. I don't know.
How about just slammed?
People like to net deck too much. Like, again, the tournament at 6-1 with this deck, literally everybody else was playing Reno Lock. So even if you play like the worst zoo possible, it's still better than the Reno Lock.
Oh, you see this sick play? Rampage on the Acolyte.
You're way too excited about the game that is over. Like, Let's keep the excitement for the next game. That will be the important ones. Like the Shaman versus the Wing is also going to be pretty easy for the Shaman. It's all going to come down to the Shaman versus the Zoo.
I mean, this is what I'm saying. This game decided the whole series. If Ignite was aggressive enough, it would have been okay if he could have won this matchup. But I mean, now you know the Shaman is mid Shaman, right? So
okay, in this particular situation, in this intrication of the ways their hands panned out, the only way he could have won was playing Peddler and then taking Blood Sail and then like using that on the Fire Water. So other than that, hands he was dealt by the Yorksaron dealer, which we have in Hearthstone, Heroes of Warcraft. That was the only way he would have won. Oh, that's a misplay. You should always play with Trowel, not with Morgloom.
Yeah, he's just not intimidating enough.
Yeah.
Especially not against Garrosh.
Oh, I forgot the Ignite has a midrange Shaman, not even an aggro Shaman.
I've been saying this the whole time.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, you're sitting there like...
with a midrange Shaman, he's fucked.
Exactly. This is why he has to lead the Zoo, right? And try and take the win. And then mid Shaman needs to be...
I was thinking that he has aggro Shaman and that aggro Shaman can like insta win against the Warrior.
Oh, no, there are no 7-7s in this deck.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
I think Ignite is playing, like, Deng Xu's list. And Deng Xu, like, very old Shaman player, loves midrange Shaman, decided that 7-7s are not good for the build. So.
Yeah. I guess the God of Hearthstone, Deng Xu, decides that.
I mean, I think he's correct, but... You know, this matchup, you could really use a 7-7 or 2.
I think it's not correct to play the midrange Shaman over the face Shaman in the first place.
Yeah, it doesn't go face enough.
It's like saying if you're playing aggro, K'tun, Nzolf, Y'Shirai, Tempo Mage, you should probably play Ragnaros in it. It's like, it doesn't matter. The deck is just bad. It doesn't matter what deck choice is.
Yeah, we shouldn't even argue about a bad deck, right?
Yeah.
Would you put Bot Creepers in your Conceit Shaman?
Again, I wouldn't play Conceit Shaman in the first place. Maybe it's a good deck. Maybe that is actually a good deck. Like,
you banned it versus me, right?
Yeah, I had to ban it versus you. And I had to put myself in a spot where I would need to like steal a win from your Zoo deck. Otherwise, I couldn't win. It was easier for me to steal from Zoo than to steal from the Shaman. Because like the Shaman is very annoying if you hit the Doomsayer and then some taunts.
I mean, you really can't steal from the Shaman if I draw fairly decent.
Yeah. The deck is actually good.
Yeah, I tested it a lot. Like the, it's off the point. Let's focus on the game. So then he goes for Mana Tide. He's happy drawing one card. Yes. And it also uses a War Axe charge, so you know there is that slight upside.
Is it though?
Not really.
If you look at the value, Osaka like is way ahead. By using the one charge to kill the 0/3 totem.
Yeah, of course. But I mean, what is the other play? You want a Horse Rider face here?
Maybe even that is better.
I mean, don't forget, RDU, this is not aggro Shaman. This is
Then what is the Horse Rider doing there? It doesn't aggro Shaman.
It's there to throw him off. Throw him off the mid-range track.
Just mix it up a little. Lightning Storm into Horse Rider into Fire Elemental. Not that great.
I mean, you do have two Storms. You don't ever really use them. It's fine to just get rid of one, I think. Although you really just trade a Storm for a 2-2, right? A 2-1 Loot Hoarder just draws a card anyway. But that's what you gotta do.
I mean, he drew the card for 2 mana. It's not free. And usually a card is like worth 1.2 mana. So, killing the Loot Hoarder, Ignite gains like still 0.8 mana.
Not like this.
I went for Life Force, sorry. Couldn't help myself. Like, since I started like talking with Life Coach, just the way of thinking changed. Like, after watching his team, you see like the things differently, like value-wise.
Yeah.
You like look at cards like assign the mana cost, like how much mana. Like for example, drawing one card out of the Mana Tide is like 1.something mana. So you still need to draw like 2 to like at least break even. Again, you have the body, so like him killing the body also like gives you mana value. But Mana Tide, even if you draw one card and he kills it using like 4 or 5 damage, you still didn't break even. You need to draw two cards and then like let him kill it, then it's fine. Did I lose you?
No, but it confuses me because so many people would just play Mana Tide on three, right? So you're saying you really want to hold off for more value. But you look at Ignite's hand, what does he have? He has two Storms, a Stormcrack, and a Lightning Bolt. I mean, you need to cycle this Mana Tide eventually,
that's why you
right?
don't play Stormcrack in your deck.
Yeah. This matchup is particularly bad. Unless you like roll Spell Power and use Stormcrack Emperor Thorzan, then it is okay, I guess.
This game seems pretty over.
Yeah. So OTK the Shaman, like through Taunt and everything, Oskok already has Blood and Execute, that would be zero mana. The Worgen and the Faceless are going to be six, I guess. Ideally, you want one more piece before playing Emperor, right?
Yeah.
Like the Charge or the Rampage to be reduced.
Yeah.
So it's okay to just hold, I guess.
Or even a Kroll Taskmaster reduced wouldn't be that bad.
The which one?
Hmm?
The Charge or something?
The Kroll Taskmaster.
Kroll Taskmaster? Yeah. That would also work out well. Seven, then you have, yeah. It's very aggressive.
Yeah, this puts Oskaka in a spot where I'm not sure if he wants to play Emperor. Oh, no, he can't play Emperor because he drew the Rampage. Does he want to do it?
I think so. This is the last turn you can very safely play it, and then you can do all your shenanigans next turn with the Pyro.
I think there's one more turn, but I'm not sure.
One more turn?
Yeah, I think that if you don't play this turn, you can play it next turn and still not die. I don't think Meteor Shaman has enough damage to burst you.
Yeah, but it's a lot riskier. You don't feel confident because like if Ignite runs like Alakir or something, you know, and he has Flame Tongue as well on the board, then you're very scared.
Okay. So now Ignite will try to like find the most efficient way to kill Emperor.
Yeah, just
and
roll spell
push damage.
Him.
And then Storm Crack the Emperor.
And Ignite's doing a good job of holding his resources. Like, even playing this Fire Elemental, I think Ignite does want to just bait the War Axe charge out, right? So you can save the Feral Spirits. And his Feral Spirits here is like, super important, just to have the taunts up after Oskaka's low on resources.
Yeah. The Horse of their positioning is not that great, by the way. Usually you want the Divine Shields on the sides.
Yeah. You should put the Fire Early, but that's okay. I mean, you can use the Trog, Spirits, and... Oh, no. Do you need to play Spirits this turn?
I don't mind it.
You're afraid of dying at 30, right?
No, but he wants to kill him next turn. I don't mind it.
Yeah,
actually,
you just gave up all your defense.
Yeah. No, Pyromancer can like wreck you.
Yeah, I think you save Spirits for reload.
I forgot about Pyromancer.
Well, Ignite goes all in. Like, just like the Leroy game, right?
Yeah.
It's...
Yeah, I forgot about Pyromancer.
It's a little premature.
Yeah.
To be fair.
Yeah, uh-huh. It's a clear. Just execute or?
Yeah, you coin Acolyte and then execute. Get your draws in.
You can coin Acolyte and then.
Yeah, execute for zero.
I-core. You can I-core coin Acolyte.
Oh, yeah, even on. Yeah, sure.
Oh, what's the most efficient way to do it?
I think the execute is fine. Oh, wait, no. Yeah, I-core's better. Yeah.
This is better.
But you do have... You have two executes stuck in your hand. It doesn't matter. For emergency situations, we have Icarus for executes left.
Haha.
Ooh, that Azure Drake. Well, Ignite is forced to pass a turn for the storm.
Yeah.
Then, it doesn't look very happy about it.
Osaka basically needs charge to win. Charge and like an Enrage / Taskmaster if he has enough mana to play them all. So it's 6, 7. Charge is 3 mana, right?
Yeah.
He needs Enrage. He cannot afford to play Taskmaster.
How many cards are left in Oskaka's deck at this point?
I can check. 12. So just in that 12 cards we have one Charge, 2 Enrages, and 1 Taskmaster.
I think Oskaka might just cycle 3 here, slam it, and then. Just Battle Rage. because, you know, Ignite still has things from below, another set of spirits. You want to make sure that you get to this combo before any of the taunts become relevant.
Fire Elemental is not bad.
That's very good.
Now, Execute comes in handy. Does the charge.
Is this it?
No, there's because no, you cannot activate the Rampage, right? Yeah. He could with the Ghoul, but it's not good enough.
Yeah, it's not enough mana. Oh, is it? Yeah, he has Rampage for one.
Hmm? Yeah, but then he cannot Faceless.
Yeah.
Okay, now this little next turn.
Hey, there it is.
Yeah, this is pretty much game over. We see Ignite pretty sad. The thing is that at this point he has to hope Osara just...
Feral Spirits. Oh no, but you have too much damage. Because one Worgen hits and then three Worgens hit face. But, you know, it's close.
Do you think it's enough damage?
Yeah. What do you mean? It's 11 damage per Worgen, right?
Yeah, but the Worgen die. Oh, he doesn't die, never mind. Rampage does not die.
Yeah, it's just 33 plus the War Axe.
He opts to play the Storm Crack instead of playing the Feral Spirits.
Whoa! He wants to get rid of War Axe, right? And save the Spirits.
Yeah, with 6 cards in the deck, maybe his best chance was just like hoping Gosaka has like the charge in the last cards of his deck.
Yeah, and hold on to Spirits. Hope he has to use War Axe.
Ignite can still make it, though. He plays against Hoi.
Mm-hmm.
And we're gonna have...
Hoi is very tilted at this point.
Yeah.
You saw Tice roll like 4 Totem Golems against him. But yeah, it's been a good series between Osaka and Ignite. Osaka bringing the Combo Warrior and showing, I think, as one of the few players to bring it, the very, very strong potential of the deck to sweep aggressive lineups and to do well against decks that really can't deal with the high burst damage.
Yeah. If Ignite didn't play Midrange Shaman, this would look differently. But then he wouldn't be able to beat you, for example, because if you play Aggro Shaman, you would farm him. So he just needs to like dodge one of you guys.
Yeah. I feel like casting with your RDU is just a lot of shots fired at every direction.
Yeah, just a machine, I don't know. I'm just having fun, man. I'm just casually casting.
Yeah, like, on the beer stream, this is what we do.
No, but seriously, like maybe people are like, oh, this RDU guy is like so offensive to everybody. Just stop taking everything so seriously. Like, nobody's getting offended here. Everybody's here to have a good time and just chill and relax and have fun, basically. Enjoying some Hearthstone. Talking about Hearthstone, we have Osaka versus Tice.
Osaka versus Tice? A repeat of
BlizzCon? On the beer stream.
On the beer stream. Ugh, they should put this one on the main stage. Can we just alert production and say, a little change
in schedule?
Yeah, just
kick the...
Yeah.
Well, that was RDU and Jasen.
I mean, I really want to cast Osaka versus Tice. So maybe we come back, but this is we're signing out for now.
And, stay tuned. Watch